conflict.
Please. Hello everyone, welcome to Under Visits. Now that superhero movies has conquered Hollywood, so we are going to look back on the most influential films in this genre. Considering this list, that origin story for where the superhero movies genre is today and where it's going in the future. Here are the most influential superhero movies of all time. Batman Begins. There were numerous attempts to revive the Batman franchise, including an adaptation of Batman Year One from Darren Aronofsky, a Batman Beyond movie, and even a Batman vs. Superman movie 12 years before Zack Snyder's version, this one from Wolfgang Peterson. Thankfully, Warner Brothers never greenlit the bat signal for any of these. Batman's cinematic salvation came from an unlikely source, a well-respected indie director named Christopher Nolan, whose combined domestic gross was less than $100 million at that time. Batman Begins brought the Caped Crusader back and changed Hollywood blockbuster filmmaking forever by launching the reboot revolution. Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman was created in 1941 and was featured in one of the 1970s most popular TV shows and belongs on the Mount Rushmore of superheroes along Batman, Superman and Spider-Man. Wonder Woman finally made her big screen debut in Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice in 2016 as a major supporting character. Finally, in 2017, Wonder Woman got her own movie, opening to $103 million and earning $412 million domestically.
Nothing good is born from lies.
Superman. Superman has been featured everywhere in his 8-decade history. He was so popular that there was even Superman Day at the New York World's Fair in 1940. That's incredible. And so is Superman.
You're the answer, son.
It's a charming adventure film that makes you feel like a little kid thumbing through the pages of a Superman comic book. Considering it came out in the nihilistic new Hollywood of the 1970s, that's saying something, especially since every other Superman franchise has failed to match its pitch-perfect tone.
Help them accomplish wonders.
Deadpool. After 16 years, moviegoers no longer got excited about X-Men movies. So how do you inject a dose of energy into you? Fox decided on the Merc with the mouth, Deadpool.
About that part, Spice.
It was a safe play as Deadpool was hard R, ultra-violent and featured a character whose only mainstream presence was a brief appearance in X-Men Origins Wolverine. Still, Deadpool looked different and the Valentine's Day, Fox got the best gift of all when the film opened to $132 million, making it not only the highest in the X-Men franchise, but the highest R-rated opening weekend ever.
Bad guys can't see me bleed.
Deadpool was the meta superhero movie we needed and it wasn't afraid to mock its genre. It provided a fresh, original superhero movie could still win big at the box office.
Give you abilities.
The Dark Knight. The Dark Knight changed Hollywood in other ways too. In The Dark Knight's wake, several blockbusters were forced to have a dark tone, much to the DCEU's creative detriment. Perhaps even more impactful, The Dark Knight's snubbing for a Best Picture nomination famously forced the Academy Awards to expand the category to include popular films.
Hello, beautiful.
Even on Oscar night, when Heath Ledger won an posthumous Academy Award for Supporting Actor, than the highest honor ever awarded to a superhero film.
This city deserves a better class.
Iron Man. There had been efforts to bring Iron Man to the big screen since the 1990s with Tom Cruise attached to star. Yet, by the time cameras finally started rolling on Iron Man, it wasn't the world's biggest movie star wearing the red and gold armor. It was a former high school dropout, drug addict and ex-con who spent his 2-decade career being labeled box office poison, Robert Downey Jr. There's no denying that RDJ was talented and his screen tests prove he was born to play Tony Stark. Iron Man exceeded all expectations when it opened to $102 million, eventually earning $318 million domestically. We still get chills remembering the first post-credit scene where Samuel L. Jackson mentions the Avengers initiative, yet none of it would have happened without Robert Downey Jr. saying, "I am
Iron Man."
Spider-Man.
You sure you want to know?
Younger viewers who has been born and raised on Spider-Man movies won't be able to understand just how anticipated the Wallcrawler's first big screen adventure was. Fans had literally waited decades for Spider-Man to join the hallowed ranks of cinematic stardom alongside the other Mount Rushmore superheroes. Spider-Man opened in 2002 to $114 million, breaking the opening weekend record and swinging into the records book as the first movie to open above $100 million. Spider-Man finished its run with $403 million domestically, launching 10 films about the web-slinger that have pulled in $7.2 billion and putting Marvel family in the top spot after decades in DC's shadow.
Genetically enhanced super spiders.
There's 14.
Black Panther.
But I have never seen anything.
Before breaking ground as vampire hunter Blade, Wesley Snipes tried to bring Black Panther to the big screen in the mid-90s. But he had his dreams dashed when Marvel filed the 11th chapter bankruptcy in 1996. Black Panther made his big screen debut as a major supporting character in 2016's Captain America Civil War, joining Team Tony to take on Captain America's crew. Black Panther's solo debut was released in 2018, and while Marvel was expecting a hit comparable to their own non-Avengers adventures, they were blown away when Black Panther opened to $202 million, the biggest opening weekend for a solo superhero movie ever. The Avengers.
What do we do?
After years spent in DC's shadow, Marvel was planning something groundbreaking. After making chump change from their previous big screen adaptations, the comics company went all in on Marvel Studios.
Prepared to do.
Marvel's ultimate goal was a historic crossover production, The Avengers. It was ambitious and no way guaranteed. Iron Man was a blockbuster, but The Incredible Hulk bombed, while Thor and Captain America the First Avenger made tidy profits.
Lose control and turn into an enormous green rage monster.
Summer 2012 was a moment of truth, and The Avengers made $207 million in its opening weekend. Joker. It's the first blockbuster superhero movie that's not a superhero movie at all. The Joker is one of the most famous comic book characters and one of the most famous villains, period. But Joker doesn't belong in the same category as The Avengers or even The Dark Knight. Joker did what no superhero movie ever has when it won the Golden Lion at the Venice Film Festival, putting it in the same conversations as Rashomon, Brokeback Mountain, and Roma. Joker's violence dominated the cultural conversation before its release, leading to a $335 million domestically.